What's up, guys? For today's quote of the day, for Wednesday, August 24th, 2016, we have Mr. Paul Coffey. Nobody's a natural. You work hard to get good, then work to get better. It's hard to stay on top. One more time, because it's just that good. Nobody's a natural. You work hard to get good, and then work to get better. It's hard to stay on top. You know, I think we get blinded because we see people who are experts at what they do. You guys remember that song by Good Charlotte? Lifestyle, for the rich and the famous. Oh yeah, that's the one. They're always complaining. So you see people who are the cream of the crop, you see people who are the best at what they do, and they're able to live these amazing, extravagant lifestyles where they're able to travel the world and do all the things that would be so cool to do. And we always wonder that one thing: will I ever be able to live like that? Will I ever be able to have a lifestyle that's second to none? Will I ever be able to do that? And the answer is yes. So as a performance coach, everyone that comes up to me, one of the first things they always say to me is, James, I want to do my passion. My passion or my skill set is blah, whatever that is. And they always say, you know, how long do you think it'll take me to become successful at? Or when do you think I can start monetizing it? Or when do you think I can start making money on it? Or what would you do if you were me and how would I start making money on that? And a lot of times what comes up is, you know, I don't know if I'm naturally good at this versus all these other people that do what I want to do. They're just naturally good at it, at whatever it is. And the first thing I always say to everybody is, when you think someone's naturally good at something, when they do it for the very first time, they're a little better than what the average person is. And when the average person does something for the very first time, usually they're not great at it. So when you meet someone who's just a little bit better than not great, they look amazing. That's what that usually means when you hear someone's naturally good at it, right? They're just better than the average person. But just because you're better than the average person does not mean you're at the cream of the crop. When you start meeting the people who are at the cream of the crop of at what you want to become great at or successful at or whatever you want to monetize at or whatever you want to be known for or whatever you want to do full-time versus working at a potential job that you may not want to work at because there's this dream that you have of what you really want to do with your life, right? And you're like, well, I don't know if I can ever be at that level. All the people that I've ever met that are independent that make at least a 6-7 figure income, I can tell you 100% non-negotiable, non-debatable, that each and every single one of them will tell you the exact same thing, which is every single day they put hours and hours and hours into that craft, right? They are naturally good at it in the sense of they just have a passion to do it, but they put hours and hours and hours and hours into that craft. And I wanted to share with everyone today that if you want to get good at something, all you have to do is put a lot of time into it. If you can meet people who are already extraordinarily good at what you want to be, and they can teach you the traits, the basic fundamentals, the basic ideologies, the basic rudiments on how to be great at it too, that can maybe shortcut it a little bit so you don't have to do the things that are wrong, and you can do it with the only things that are right, so you don't have to learn from your mistakes. But even after you know all that, you have to be willing to put hours and hours and hours and hours and hours into that craft. You know, it's kind of like a little kid that's learning how to tie his or her shoelaces for the very first time, and they get that knot and they're frustrated and they quit and they say, Velcro forever, I quit, I'm never gonna wear shoes with laces. And then you say, no, calm down, right? You'll get good at it, I promise you. I used to get knots too, and then I got really good at it, and then I started tying my shoelaces, and the next thing you know, I was really good at tying my shoelaces, right? Because I'm 34, don't worry, honey, I've been tying my shoes for like 30 years. So I look like I'm good at tying my shoelaces, but it's not that I'm good, I've just been doing it so long, right? And that's our skill sets, that's our craft. So if you have a vision, ambition, desire, and goal, if you have this thing that you wanna be great at, if you have this thing that you're like, you know what, I wanna do this full time, or if you're already doing it, but it's not full time yet, you're thinking, will I ever get there? I can promise everybody, as long as you don't quit and you have the proper direction and you keep on putting hours and hours and hours and hours into making yourself better and never want to stop learning on how to become so great at whatever that is, you'll look like a natural to someone who's just beginning, and you're gonna look at them and say, you know what? I'm actually not a natural at it. I've just put a lot of time into it, just like how I put a lot of time into tying my shoelaces. I can do it with my eyes closed. That's how good I am. And the truth is, you wouldn't look at someone 34 years old who can tie their shoes with their eyes closed as good. You would just look at them saying, well, yeah, I can do that too. Because you put that much time into tying your shoelaces too. right? So if you are willing to put as much time as you put into learning how to brush your teeth with your eyes closed, if you're willing to learn how to tie your shoelaces, if you can put all that time into those things, but you can put into your skill set, in time, you're gonna look like you're naturally good at something, and then to stay on top, you just have to put time in and never wanna stop learning to be great at something. So thanks guys, I hope you liked today's quote of the day by Mr. Paul Coffey. If you did like it, let me know, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can get a quote every single day. I would love to hear your feedback on how you took Mr. Paul Coffey's quote. And then if you have a favorite quote, I would love for you to leave it in the comments below and get me all jacked up about it so I can get inspired by your favorite quote of all time. And until next time, you guys have a super day. I'll see you guys tomorrow.